breakthrough in HIV treatment, targeting HIV-infected cells. In a groundbreaking revelation unveiled at the recent Conference on Retroviruses and Opportunistic Infections, CROI 2024, discussions centered on potential drugs and treatments that could advance HIV cure research. Notably, two presentations highlighted the promising concept of targeted activation of cell kill TACK, abbreviated as TACK. This approach involves pinpointing infected cells and triggering their self-destruction. I am Dr. Kayode, and you are watching Zoom Hospital Channel. TACK drugs exhibit the capability to induce HIV-infected cells to undergo self-destruction, potentially serving as potent agents for HIV treatment and contributing to a cure by targeting and eliminating reservoir cells. The drugs are capable of turning the virus's own cell-killing mechanisms against it. Remember that we have said in earlier videos that one of the reasons why HIV is difficult to cure is because of the way HIV hides in a small number of long-lived reservoir cells, which stay inactive as long as antiretroviral therapy is there to suppress it. While stem cell transplants have achieved elimination in a few individuals, this approach is prohibitively risky and expensive for widespread use. This novel approach involves drugs that repurpose the virus's own cell-killing machinery against itself. Certain drugs, such as efavirenz and rilpivirine at a very high dose, exhibit a secondary property called TACK, which prompts premature self-destruction of cells harboring HIV genes, thereby inhibiting the production of viable viral particles. TACK may be employed independently or as part of a kick-and-kill strategy to target latent reservoir cells for elimination. Unlike approaches reliant on immune responses, TACK drugs offer a direct method of cell killing. Groundbreaking results in mice studies. In groundbreaking experiments conducted on mice, TACK drugs demonstrated unprecedented efficacy in reducing HIV viral load. After just one or two doses, viral load is reduced in the treated mice, with some even achieving undetectable levels. It also causes direct cell death of the infected cells. The speed and potency of TACK drugs in suppressing viral replication far surpassed conventional treatments, offering new hope in the battle against HIV. However, further research is essential to validate the safety and efficacy of TACK drugs in humans, particularly considering the cytotoxic effects associated with cell killing. Additionally, questions remain regarding the ability of TACK drugs to sufficiently target and eliminate quiescent reservoir cells, thereby achieving a durable reduction in the HIV reservoir. Imagine a drug that not only disables HIV's ability to replicate, but also triggers infected cells to commit suicide. Sounds like science fiction? Think again. Early studies, conducted in the mouse models, showcased the breathtaking efficacy of these TACK drugs. Within days, viral loads plummeted, leaving behind a trail of defeated virus particles. But here's the real game changer, the speed of action. Unlike their conventional counterparts, TACK drugs act swiftly, delivering a knockout blow to the virus within days, not weeks. Even after just one dose, viral loads nosedived, hinting at the dawn of a new era in HIV treatment. Yet, amidst the excitement, caution remains the watchword. Before these drugs can be hailed as saviors, rigorous testing in human trials is imperative. Safety is paramount, especially when dealing with drugs capable of inducing cell death. Moreover, the ultimate test lies ahead. Subscribe and hit the notification bell for updates on this groundbreaking research as scientists continue to push the boundaries of HIV treatment and strive towards a cure. What are your thoughts on TACK drugs and their potential in HIV treatment? Share your insights and questions below. You can contact us via the link in the description below for any medical inquiry.